please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Halftime Report. I'm Sumaira Abdi. With me is Nigel D'Souza. Well, for the market, we've just been meandering in the 20-30 point range through the day, but it's a day for mid-caps. And there's news coming through on Vakrangi. The stock is up now 5%. They have announced that they would be allocating about 1,000 crore rupee for a share buyback. So that's good news for investors. I'm just trying to open some more details.
Okay. Sumaira, you know, if you take a look at it, the current market capitalization is around 22,000 crores of Vakrangi. You know, the stock has corrected from around 515 levels on 24 January. Now, 1,000 crores will be roughly around 4.5% to around 5% of the current market capitalization. So, you know, remember what really triggered off this entire storm was that they bought around 112 crores of shares of PC Jewelers. So it's good to see, if you have money in your books, go ahead and support your own stock price. You know, don't go ahead and buy another listed company. So that's some news that's come in there. Remember, it's been a big, big underperformer. A lot of retail audience has been stuck in this one. Pull up a last 1 month chart. You'll see the stock has corrected from around 515 levels all the way to around 200 level. Just take a look at that, 50% down. But some support coming in for some of those investors as well. At current reckoning, it'll be around 22,000 crores of market cap. And 1,000 crores buyback, that will equate to around 4.5%. Yes, Sumaira.
And the promoter and promoter group are not participating.
That's an important piece of information that Sumaira is giving as well. So then the acceptance ratio goes up. So as Sumaira is telling us that, in fact, the promoter and the promoter group will not be participating. The promoter holds roughly around 41.7%. When the promoter group doesn't participate, then the acceptance ratio will be higher, assuming the remaining, you know, 58% of the people, all of them tender in. So the lower number of people that tender in, then the acceptance ratio goes up. Promoter doesn't participate, then the acceptance ratio goes up even more. So, you know, good to see that they're coming in there and they're supporting the stock price as well, Sumaira.
All right, so that's the news flow coming through on Vakrangi.
Let's focus on the first stock that we have on the show. Well, Sarda Energy, that's been a big, big outperformer in the last 1 year or so. In fact, Mr. Tulsian has been very, very positive on this stock in the recent past, at least for more than the last 1 year or so. And if you pull up a last 1 year chart, you'll see it's more than doubled your money. But, you know, the numbers, well, they were more or less a mixed quarter. Or there was some weakness, and that explains why there is some mild profit booking that we're seeing in today's trading session. But to understand what's going on there, well, we have with us Mr. Jain, Padam Jain, the director of the company who joins in. Hi, Mr. Jain. Thanks so much, sir, for joining in. First things first, the big highlight in the last quarter was pellet prices as well as pellet volumes. If you could help us out with what were the total sales volumes of the pellet segment and approximate pricing, what was it?
Yeah, very good afternoon.
Yeah.
Last quarter, we had a pellet volume of about 125,000 tons.
Wow.
Which is above average of 1 lakh tons in last two quarters. So far as pricing is concerned, pellet prices in the third quarter have seen about 10% increase over the second quarter.
10% in the third quarter versus the second quarter. And as of today, the pricing is still as strong. If you could give us a number, sir, what is it? Is that around $110 on a per ton basis? So will quarter four realizations of pellet be better than quarter three?
Substantially higher.
Okay.
In quarter three, we were having an average of about 5,500, and now prevailing price is around 6,800 to 7,000 rupees a ton. So there is a substantial increase of about 25% over the third quarter.
Mr. Jain, good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, very good afternoon.
Steel business remains robust. The ferro alloys business, you know, there remain some concerns over there. What's the strategy in terms of when you hope things will turn around?
No, ferro alloys is the reason for a fall in the ferro alloys production is basically shutdown of one of our captive power plants.
Oh, okay.
That was the reason for reduction in the ferro alloys volumes. And in the fourth quarter, we have started bringing power from our wholly owned subsidiary from Vishakhapatnam to Raipur. So in fourth quarter, we will be able to maintain our ferro alloys volumes at standalone level also. And in subsidiary, there is a substantial jump in the ferro alloys volumes of about 30%.
Okay, so this plant which you're talking about, which has a shutdown, are we looking at restarting it anytime soon?
This will be started back in March.
In March. Okay. So
but whatever shortfall is there, presently we are meeting from our subsidiaries, captive power plant.
Okay. All right. So by, you know, for the next year, then in fact, for the first quarter of FY19, everything will be back to normal. You'll have this plant that will be restarted,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, everything will be normal, and in first quarter we'll be able to start our expanded capacity of steel plant also.
All right. You know, sir, let's just focus on the standalone margins that you've given. It's come in at roughly around 20%. Now, going by what you are saying, that pellet prices are much higher, you have some part of your, you know, iron ore supply that's integrated. So can we expect 100 or 200 basis points expansion in margins for the fourth quarter?
Yeah,
is that fair to say?
It should be.
200 basis points we can go with?
Yeah, it should be 100 to 200 point comfortably, because margins have improved, and to some extent it will be offset by the increase in the raw material prices. But to the extent we have captive iron ore, that will be increasing our margins. And in addition to also, there we have been able to get a little bit better margins than the raw material price increase.
So you've also refinanced some loans, I understand. What is your current debt situation?
Current total long-term debt is about 1100 crores, and the total debt including working capital is about 1450 crores.
And as Sumera just asked, sir, what is the current borrowing rate? Have you refinanced some of that borrowing cost?
No, in third quarter we have not refinanced any. Some loans were refinanced prior to third quarter, and remaining we are planning to refinance in this quarter.
In this one. So currently your borrowing rate is what? 9.25?
No, overall borrowing rate is about 10.5%. That should come down by 1% minimum.
1% minimum by quarter four?
Yeah, quarter four end.
All right. Final question, sir. Demand is as strong on the ground. You know, are you seeing any kind of let up, or do you think quarter four you're seeing strong demand on the ground? There is some rumors floating in the markets that maybe, you know, enough of stock is not being picked up. You're seeing no hindrances in terms of demand. It's as strong?
No, we are not seeing any hindrance in the demand so far.
All right. So things are looking good.
Yeah.
All right, Mr. Jain, thanks so much, sir, for joining in on your positive commentary, expecting 100 to 200 basis points expansion of margins. Well, the stock is spiking up as we speak. It's recovered from the low point of the day. By the way, we have Zuari Agro that's come out with a set of numbers. The stock is flying away. They've come in with a net profit, but that's also because of a MAT credit, I think, Sumera.
Yeah, that's true, actually. So they have, I think, about 11 crores in terms of a MAT credit. But I think even if you take that out, their performance looks quite good this time around. And understandably now, the stock reacting exceedingly well. Okay, a total tax credit of about 15 crores.
Just keep an eye out. You know, we had some numbers that were flashing for you on the screen. We had Zuari that had come out. Zuari Agro actually had come out with a set of numbers. It looked like a very, very strong set of numbers. And that's why the stock did take off. The net profit was at around 48 crores that compares with around 4 crores. But keep in mind, there's a MAT credit and there's a tax credit as well. So 11 crores of that is close to a MAT credit. And, you know, there's a tax credit of around 15 crores. So nearly around 26 crores out of that is because of this tax credit that we're having. Yes, the top line, there was a growth. Yes, there was an operational jump in terms of the EBITDA number as well. The revenue has grown by 46%. You have the EBITDA number as well, that's up 35%. But if you look at the margins, well, it's at around 8.8%. And that's a tad bit lower if you compare it with around 9.5%. So the first number, it looked very, very strong. It looked like a tenfold jump in terms of net profit. But keep in mind, there's a MAT credit as well as there's a tax credit of close to around 26 crores or thereabouts, 11 crores and tax credit as well. Our ticker team had put that up for you. Just keep that in mind. Otherwise, the numbers operationally as well look fairly good. But talking about earnings, Sarda Communications, that one's on our radar. After the company posted a good set of earnings this quarter, the revenue was down close to around 6%, but the operational efficiency led to stronger margins. To understand what's going on there and what's the outlook going ahead, we have with us Ms. Pratibha Advani, the CFO of the company. Hi, Ms. Advani. Thanks so much, ma'am, for joining in today. Well, in the consolidated revenues, there was a slight downtick in terms of revenues. Can you give us the reasoning for this?
You know, you have to peel our results like onion gently. The degrowth in the revenues is on account of voice, but we have been sharing that our entire business focus is growth of our data services revenue. And that portfolio has been growing significantly. Our growth services year on year for the quarter have grown by 38.5%. Our traditional services portfolio has grown by 5.6%. And that's a $1 billion portfolio. So if you actually look, and some of the products in that portfolio in our data services are industry leading growth, and they're growing by double digit. So VPN, IPL, ILL, these are all growing by double digit. Our UCC portfolio, which is part of our growth services, is growing by upwards of 20% year on year. So if you actually see, the reason for our strong performance is on the back and strength of the growth that we are seeing in our overall data services portfolio. And if we also look at our subsidiaries, our transformation services has grown by 12.5% year on year, with again coming in with strong EBITDA margins. Our payment solutions business had been impacted by demonetization. That is rebounding, and by next quarter, that business should break even. So every part of our data services portfolio has been performing very well.
Ms. Advani, good afternoon. In the traditional business, margins have come in quite high this time, I think almost 31.5%. What led to this, and is this level now sustainable?
That is right. The margins have very strong margins we've delivered on our traditional portfolio. This is on the back of a couple of reasons. Firstly, we have had some good customer wins. We've been able to hold on to a churn that we were witnessing in the earlier quarters. And because of razor sharp focus on our costs, we had started some productivity initiatives early on in the year, and those have borne fruit.
Well, Ms. Advani, have you gained any market share in the enterprise business? Some of your competitors, they're reeling with high debt.
We already had the lion's share in the enterprise business in India. We are also witnessing a very steady growth in the enterprise business outside of India. So while the India enterprise business is growing by 9% year on year, our international business is growing by 11% year on year.
Okay, what are the opportunities that you see in terms of the movement to 5G, and also what's the revenue potential there?
We think 5G would be beneficial because it's going to lead to more and more data consumption, and increase in data consumption helps us and helps grow our business opportunity. It's also another way of access. So 5G would only complement growth for us.
Well, Ms. Advani, I want to understand your geographic breakup. What percentage of your revenues come in from abroad? And are the margins over there better than the domestic business?
Our margins in the domestic business are better because in the international business, we are dependent on other service providers for last mile access. However, having said that, while that is true for the traditional services, in the growth services, we would see the quality of margins for both businesses to be similar.
What's the update in terms of the land demerger?
We have filed our application for approval with SEBI, and the approval is awaited. So it's a good positive development that has happened. And by August, September timeframe, we should see this activity conclude.
Precisely. That's a good positive development. We'll keep an eye out on that timeline as well. But could you give us some guidance for FY19, FY18 as well, in terms of revenue as well as what are the margins we can look at?
While we don't give formal guidance, all that I can say is that you would continue to see the growth momentum, both in the revenue and in margin expansion.